Hello dear students, today we are going to discuss about the theory of simple banding. So first is what do you understand by the banding? The simple meaning of the banding, that means we will take a simple rod and if we apply the load, the curvature of the beam will be like this, and this is known as banding. So this is the simple, very simple meaning of the banding. Now we have to discuss the banding and what is the pure banding. So first, when a beam is subjected to an external transverse loading, the beam will be bent. The stress induced in the beam to resist the bending movement is called as bending stresses. Bending stresses change linearly from compression to tensile zone, and it is denoted by the sigma. So basically, if we start with this, so first we'll take a beam. When we apply the load, this load will generate the bending movement. As we all know, the definition of bending movement. Bending movement is the movement of all the vertical forces, either right or left part of the section. So when we applied the load, it will generate the bending movement. After generating the bending movement, the effect of the bending movement, it will try to bend the beam. When the beam started bending, this bending will generate the stress. This stress is known as bending stress. Now, listen, if we talk about the beam, we will say that our beam is formed with so many layers. These all pages of these diaries are, suppose this is a simple section of a beam, and we will taking different beam in a form of different layers. When we applied load, the upper zone is in compression and the lower zone, this particular page is in tension and the upper page is in compression. So the bending stress which linearly changes from compression to tension. So this is the bending stresses, how it will change from compression to tension. And in between that, there is a layer where there is no compression or no tension, and that layer is known as neutral layer. Us layer ko main kya kehta hu? That is known as neutral layer. So moving further, we will denote bending stress by sigma, which is equal to m by z, where m is the movement of resistance and z is the section modulus. Bending is a major concept in the design of a structure and machine components such as beam, girder and axle of the wheel. Now we come to the simple bending or pure bending. When a beam is subjected to a constant bending movement, no shear stress are induced in the portion of the beam is called as simple or pure bending. Basically, what he is saying, when a beam, it is only subjected to a bending movement, not to any shear stress, that particular beam is known as a beam which is subjected to the pure bending or simple bending. Basically, the best example, a simply supported beam ABCD is subjected to two equal load W at equal distance A from the E support as shown in the figure. This is the figure. This is the best example of the pure bending. In this case, if we draw the bending moment and shear force diagram, so this is the shear force diagram. Take, you will have this much amount of shear force on this side and this much amount of shear force on this side, and in between B and C we don't have any type of shear force, but at that same point we will have a bending moment whose magnitude is W into A. So this is the bending moment at the section BC. So BC is a section where the beam is subjected to the bending movement only. There is no shear stresses at this section. In the shear force diagram, the shear force between the point B, C is zero, as shown in the shear force diagram. In the bending movement diagram, the bending movement between the BC is constant. The portion BC is said to be the portion which is in the pure bending. So this portion is known as a portion which is subjected to the pure bending. So in my sense, or in a general sense, a pure bending section is a section where the beam is only subjected to a bending moment, not to the shearing stress. So that portion is known as pure bending, a portion subjected to the pure bending or simple bending. Now we talk about the nature of bending stresses. So before discussing that, we will consider two type of the beam. First is simply supported beam. Second is cantilever beam. When we talk about the simply supported beam, this is the arrangement of the simply supported beam. We will take one beam. These are the two supports. This is the cross section of the beam. When we apply load on the beam, the beam will bend in this manner. So in this manner, when we talk about, as we all discussed earlier, then the upper face is compressive face and the lower one is the tensile face. In between them, there is a phase where the no stress is induced. That layer is known as neutral layer. Okay. So the maximum stress at the top we are getting, that is compressive stress, which is denominated by sigma c. And at the lower end, we will get the sigma t, that is the maximum tensile bending stress. So these are the two natures of the stresses in the simply supported beam we are getting. See, these are the, this is before loading, simple beam, and this is after loading. Okay. If a beam does not load it, the beam will be shown as shown in the figure. This is the beam without any loading. Whenever the beam is loaded, the beam will be bent in such a way that it produces compressive stress in the upper layer and tensile stress in the lower layer as shown in the figure. The beam is subjected to the sagging bending movement. And the nature of this type of movement is known as sagging. Okay. Now, come to the second, that is cantilever beam. A cantilever beam is a type of beam which is fixed at one end and free at another end. This is the simple arrangement of the cantilever beam where they are with its cross section. Now, this is the before bending and after bending. When I talk about this, this is the nature. Yeah, this is the fixed end. This is the free end. Up when we applied load, so the upper layer will become in tension and the lower layer will become in the compression. So this is the basic and major difference between the cantilever and simply supported beam. Whenever a cantilever beam is loaded, the beam will bend in such a way that it will produce tensile stress at the upper layer and compressive stress in the lower layer as shown in the figure. And as we discussed with the help of this scale. Once again, I am showing you, this is the fixed end, this is the free end. When we applied load, this is the curvature of the bending beam and this layer, upper layer is in tension and the lower one is in the compression. The beam is subjected to the hogging movement and this type of curvature is known as hogging bending movement. So this is the curvature of beam, cantilever beam after loading. So at the upper end, upper face, we will get the tensile stress and at the lower stress, we will get the compressive. Basically, when we talk about the both type of beam, if the beams are symmetrical, then the distance of the neutral axis or neutral layer is a layer where there is no tension and compression in the beam. So when we talk about the neutral layer, in the distance of the topmost fiber and lowermost fiber is equal, so that the maximum tensile stress and maximum compressive stress are equal in this type of beam. In which type of beam? In the symmetrical beam, in terms of P and D. So this type of stresses, which is bending stresses in the symmetrical beams, are equal in the tensile as well as in compressive zone. So what we have studied today, what is the bending stress, what is bending, then after what is the pure bending, equation of the bending, and after that the arrangements of the simply supported beam, and what is the shape after the beam, after the loading, and what are the hogging, sagging, bending movements, neutral layer kya hoti hai, and what about the compressive stresses and tensile stresses. And in the simply supported beam, the compressive layer lies on the top and tensile at the bottom. On the other hand, in the cantilever beam, the tensile layer will lay at the top and compressive layer at the bottom. So this is all about for this next lecture we will discuss about the neutral axis and all this thing. Till then, bye, stay home, stay safe.